In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, good people of God. Today is Saturday, the 13th of February, 2021. You are listening to Catholic Meditation, and I am Father Blessed Ambang Njume. Good morning, and thanks for joining us. Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. The first reading is taken from the book of Genesis, chapter 3, verses 9 to 24. The Gospel is taken from St. Mark, chapter 8, verses 1 to 10. I read from the first reading. But Yahweh God called to the man. "Where are you?" he asked. "I heard the sound of you in the garden," he replied. "I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." "Who told you that you were naked?" he asked. "Have you been eaten from the tree I forbade you to eat?" The man replied, "It was the woman you put with me. She gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then Yahweh God said to the woman, "Why did you do that?" The woman replied, "The snake tempted me, and I ate." Then Yahweh God said to the snake, "Because you have done this, accursed be you of all animals, wild and tame. On your belly you will go, and on dust you will feed as long as you live. I shall put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. It will bruise your head, and you will strike its heel." To the woman he said, "I shall give you intense pain in childbearing. You will give birth to your children in pain. Your yearning will be for your husband, and he will dominate you." To the man he said, "Because you listened to the voice of your wife and ate from the tree of which I had forbidden you to eat, accursed be the soil because of you. Painfully will you get your food from it as long as you live. It will yield you bambrus and thistles as you eat the produce of the land. By the sweat of your face will you earn your food until you return to the ground as you were taken from it? For dust you are, and to dust you shall return." The man named his wife Eve, because she was the mother of all those who live. Yahweh God made tunics of skins for the man and his wife and clothed them. Then Yahweh God said, "Now that the man has become like one of us in knowing good from evil, he must not be allowed to reach out his hand and pick from the tree of life too, and eat and live forever." So Yahweh God expelled him from the Garden of Eden to till the soil from which he had been taken. He banished the man, and in front of the Garden of Eden, he posted the great winged creatures and the fiery flashing sword to guard the way to the tree of life. The Word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul. Worship His holy name. Sing like never before, oh my soul. worshiped your holy name. The song comes up, it's a new day dawn. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the
We must win the war against the devil. We must win the war against the devil. Again today, beloved of God, we reflect and meditate from the book of Genesis. Today we see the consequence of sin. Adam and Eve have used their free will wrongly. They have chosen to rebel against God and to do what God forbade them to do. Now, they have many consequences to face. One, they lose their innocence. They realize they are naked and are ashamed. This is what sin does. Two, they are far from God. After losing innocence, sin takes them far and farther away from God. Now, they hide from God when they hear His voice. The very God they used to come close to and move about with in the garden, now when they heard His voice, they ran and hid. Guilt. Sin brings fear, but obedience to God's will makes us live in love. One who is obedient lives in love. He does not live in fear. But sin makes you a slave and a prisoner because you are no longer free. This is the consequence of sin. Three, finally, and worst of them all, they lose their happiness. We remember that the Garden of Eden was a microcosm of heaven, the place of perfect happiness. But with the sin, the consequence was simple. Sorrow set in and death. They are out of the garden. They are out of paradise. If we read the concluding verses of today's passage, we are told that after sending them away from the garden, God prevented them from eating from the tree of life. And in front of the gate of Eden, He put the two-winged creatures. This is a symbol that man was thrown out of paradise. We were thrown out of heaven, as it were. And to get back into that heaven, we must wrestle against the devil, conquer him before we can return to paradise. They had to begin fending for themselves. Pain became man's daily reality. That was paradise lost. The woman had to undergo pain in childbearing, and the man had to undergo pain to till the soil, to labor before putting food on his table. Dear friends, this is where suffering began. With the sin of Adam and Eve, paradise was lost. Death came and man began to suffer. And we are told in the passage that the man would labor and labor just to feed his family. And that is what happens. That a man may sweat and labor all his life, yet, just within the twinkle of a finger, he needs to spend all that money to fend for his wife and his family. What lessons do we learn and how can we apply to this passage in our daily lives? First, dear friends, we should know and understand that we are deciders of our own fate. God does not send us to heaven or hell, no. If you find yourself in heaven, you took yourself there. And if you find yourself in hell, you decided to go there as well. God respects your decision made out of your free will. This song in Pidgin that we always sing says, if you no go heaven, now who you go blame? You have yourself to blame, beloved. because you have the yam and the knife. You have the free will to choose good or to choose evil. So if you do not go to heaven, the choice is yours. It is your decision. Your destiny is in your hands. Your fate is decided by yourself. Second, we should always learn to accept our faults and not push blames on others. After they had eaten of the fruit, the first person who was confronted was Adam. And God asked him, "Adam, why did you eat of the fruit?" He was guilty. Simple, he would have said, "God, I am sorry." But he was looking for who to blame. "Ah, it was the woman. The woman you put with me, she gave me and I ate." What Adam simply meant was, "God, you see, I am a good guy. Were it not for Eve, I would not have eaten of the fruit." But Eve did not force him. She gave it to him, he took and ate freely. But here he was, trying to apportion blame. And when Eve was confronted, I would not have eaten were it not for the devil. Beloved, when we commit sin, we should learn to accept responsibility for it. Many times people are never sorry for the things they do. "I would not have if he did not. I would not have if she did not." And that is how we push blame on others and fail to accept responsibility for the wrong that we do. Learn to accept your fault. Learn to take responsibility for the things that you do. Third, the battle with the devil was commenced with the sin of Adam and Eve. The moment they ate of the tree, the battle was commenced. With the fall of man, we have begun a war against the devil. In today's passage, God said, "I will put enmity between you and the woman, between your seed and your seed." And from that moment, God waged war against the devil. The battle against the devil is real. The devil is still roaming about, looking for who to deceive, as he did to Adam and Eve. Therefore, St. Peter warns, we must stand up to him strong in faith. We have to win the war. Therefore, we must restore our paradise that was lost. In order to return to that heaven, we must conquer the devil. We may lose battles. We may fall into some temptation. But, beloved, we must endeavor to win the war at the end. How? By being conscious of the fact that the devil is real and he moves about looking for who to deceive. You cannot conquer the devil if you do not know him and do not know his tricks. You cannot win an opponent in a fight if you do not know your opponent and how he fights. We have seen football players, before embarking on a match against an opponent, they watch previous videos of the matches of their opponents to see their play style. In that way, they best know how to attack. If you do not know the devil and how cunning he is, you may easily be taken away and taken unawares. Therefore, today's passage invites us to be conscious about the devil, not to fear him though, but to know his tricks and how to conquer him. For we cannot return to paradise. We cannot restore our paradise lost if we do not conquer the devil in this battle. But God assures us, he does not leave us alone. He gives us his graces. It is not as if he has abandoned man. He continues to give us the graces that we need, like bullets to fight the devil. But again, we need to cooperate with the graces that God gives us in order to conquer the devil. If not, beloved, we shall not win the war. Let us pray today for that grace, that God may always sustain us with his grace, and we on our part may cooperate with the graces, so that no matter how strong the devil may come, no matter how cunning he may seem to be, we may be wise enough to stand against him in faith and to conquer him, so that when our earthly sojourn is over, we may return to that paradise, that one-time Garden of Eden that was prepared for us, so that we shall see God face to face and enjoy his blessedness forever as it was in the beginning. Amen. Catholic meditation with me, Father Blessed. The Lord be with you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come on you and remain with you forever. Amen. We wish each and every one of you a blessed weekend.